And we're back. Welcome back, everybody. I cannot believe that I am able to show you Pulip Eos in this video. I honestly don't know why I got so lucky recently, but I'm not complaining. As you can see, I did unbox the doll herself. Here is my baby, but all of her accessories are still in box. And so it is also going to be kind of a first impression video, I guess, because I am going to unbox all of her stuff and show you immediately. Eos herself is 8 years old by now. She was released in 2010 as part of Groove Inc.'s first steampunk series. And she is a limited edition girl, so there are only 2,000 Eoses in the world. So yeah, see you in a bit. So this took a while. She did come with a lot more stuff than I knew. Honestly, guys, I knew that her box was full of goodies, but she is wearing so much stuff right now. And I want to get a few things out of the way first. First of all, here is her card. She looks very, very cute on here. But you do not only get her card, but also a certificate. And this one here states that she is number 431 of 2,000 dolls. And yeah, she's Pulip Steampunk Project Eos, and she does remind me a lot of a version of the Greek mythological figure Icarus. I know that there is also an Icarus in her doll family, but just look at all of her gear over here. And after that, I have to show you her wings. It is absolutely, absolutely amazing what she comes with. And I am so in awe. I honestly don't know how to tackle this video now. And also, oh, I'm sorry. I have no idea what this is. So if anybody knows where to put this thingy over here, I guess it has to do with the accessories that she is wearing on her arm, because she comes with this big golden stick over here, which has some chain on it. And it's really long. It is almost as tall as her. It goes all the way up to her shoulders. And then she also has these, I guess, measurement device over here, which looks really cool. It has a strap of its own, so you can put it around Eos's shoulder. I think that it looks very, very interesting. So yeah, we have that over here. And now she should be stable enough that I can show you her wings from the side. Whoa. They are honestly so big, I had to push back my tripod a bit so that they fit in the frame. But you can see that there is a lot going on. You have a lot of silver, bronze and brown. And they are also out of a light plastic, so they can flutter a bit. But I do feel like they are quite fragile, because you can see the way they are fastened They go around Ilse's shoulders, and then there is just a tiny part connecting them over here. So the wings come separately, and then there is just this tiny plastic bar to hold them together. Here they are on the other side. I did push all of Ilse's hair on one side so that I could get them on. And there are a few flyaways. I'm sorry about that, but you can see that they are about twice of Ilse's width, so they are massive. And to be honest, I am going not to display them on her directly because I feel like they eat up a lot of space. But at the same time, as a fan of Pulips with really great concepts, I'm not complaining at all. I am now going to trying to take these off and show you the rest of Ilse's stock. Just a quick looks on the wings themselves so that you can grasp their size without the doll, and also the many many details, as well as the construct which is keeping it on your pull-ups back. Something I have always underestimated is Ilse's head, because in real life it is very very heavy, because as you can see it is full of metal details. You have various studs and all kinds of metallics on here, and in the back it is ornate as well with more metallic elements, but at the same time it is very long to balance out the heaviness on the front, and then you got more metallics. And of course you also get these different types of camouflage colored patches which give her a very distinct look when she is wearing her hat. And honestly, just when you take it off, it is heavy. Now, for her eyes, she has this type of, it's not an eye patch. I am not sure if it is called a monocle in English as well. It is a monocle in German, FYI. But you can still see her eye through this, which I really like. And I feel like you can see that she is all about exploring. And of course you got the various stud steampunk details over here as well. Various brass elements all the way to the back in different colors and different kinds of metal. And the fun thing about this is that you do get these things over here with more studs, and they do not have any purpose other than being more awesome. And also, I like that this fastens in the back with Velcro. Honestly though, I am always a big scaredy cat when it comes to accessories sitting directly on my pull-ups face or on my pull-ups forehead, because I am afraid of scratching or materials staining the doll's face or body. So please be extra careful with any kinds of accessories that might hurt your pull-up in the end. And the reason why I wanted Eos, of course, is her beauty itself, because she has one of the most iconic face-ups that I have seen on Pulip. I will talk about her wig in a second, that's a whole nother story, but Eos has very fierce and beautiful eyebrows, which are completely covered by the thick bangs of her wig. And I just think that these fierce eyebrows make her look quite different than with eyebrows. With her bangs, I think that she is very, very sweet. But then here's the fierceness, Commando. You can see she has a plan. And she's not going to stop until she reaches her goals, which is amazing. So, and then, together with her versatility, I should say, you have these very, very cute lower lashes and upper lashes. She's a very lashy girl. I love that about Pulips. And during that period in 2010, you get those very nice, colorful lower lashes. I know that white is not practically a color, but it suits her so, so well, especially with the light white eyeshadow in her crease with the very subtle lilacs and slight grays, and this also suits her blushing very, very well, which is a dusty rose color, which is always such a nice combination with a lilac in my opinion. And then of course her lips are such favorites of mine, because her upper lip is not very full, but it is full enough to have this rosy lilac color, which is very prominent in the middle. She has a very full lower lip, and it is very, very glossy, which makes her very, very youthful, in my opinion. Her eyelids are another favorite of mine. They do not close all the way down like we are used to from newer Pulip releases, but I do feel that it is amazing what kind of deep burnt bronze is coming our way when she closes her eyes. It is very brassy, very metallic, and very, very steampunk-like, which I just think is so iconic. Eos's eye chips are gray. You might not see them very well from some angles, but they are actually gray. Even before I got her, I knew that her wig would be kind of a touchy subject for me, because first of all, I love it. I love the color, I love the style. I think that Eos is very, I'm going to say iconic for the 500th time or even more, but I think that Eos is a very iconic Pulip, and so I always picture her with that white creamy hair. But at the same time, her wig, as I have heard from numerous other collectors, really isn't in best shape when you get her directly out of the box. I know that some people do work with the wig and boil it and make it softer, but I am just not sure what to do. Basically, the wig is very long. I will show you right here. It goes all the way down to her legs, and every time I am brushing it, it is shedding. I am not kidding you. I'm not talking about, you know, when there are just full hairs coming out of the brush, but they are tiny, tiny little hairs, and they just keep falling out of her wig, and I don't know where all of those tiny fibers are coming from, so I will have to think about that. Also, when you zoom in on her face, you will see that she has this nice pony in the front, these nice bangs, and then she has those those strands on the sides which frame her face, and which again I love. I think that this is so very cute, but then unfortunately you have the yellowing of the wig cap on top of her head. And yes, I'm not really sure what to do about that. I mean, maybe ignoring is the best, because she's pretty no matter what. And I will also show her wig from the back, because, you know, apart from the older quality and that she has been in the box for 8 years, which you will see from this kink over here, the style of the wig is very cute, and I love that it is so long and flowy. It is not practical at all for an adventurer like Eos, but at the same time, you know, she is still taking care of her hair. This rhymes. What Eos is also taking care of is her pretty outfit. Basically, she is wearing a very functional outfit consisting out of a khaki colored blouse with a faux leather tie. Is this a tie? It's very long, but it looks like a tie. Then she is wearing a belt out of faux snake leather. There you go, here is the belt, and you can also see that it is actually connected to her faux leather suspenders. Here is some olive green fabric underneath, and then there is her skirt, which is black and white with some embellishments of brass and chains. And you know, I at first thought that this was a pair of trousers, but it actually is an asymmetrical skirt, which looks like that from the back. Her sock and boot combo is absolutely crazy. She is wearing these very nice laced leather boots, which do look very, very big for her feet. And her socks have more of the fake snake print in the front, and in the back they are ripped khaki cotton socks. And because her top had some suspenders, you also get some suspender action over her socks over here. Also, please take a look at the brass elements. And then she also has some string attached. I guess that this is attached to her top. Her arms are covered in pretty basic black gloves, and you can feel that she is wearing plastic underneath it so that the black won't stain her body. And then she also got these devices on each arm, which I guess are here to protect her elbow and to help her hold her gadgets. This is its look from behind, which is perfectly elbow shaped, although way too big for a pull-up. This has been my review about Steampunk Project Tulip Eos from 2010. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and that you might have taken a liking to her. I had been looking for her for a really long time, so I am really happy that she is home. I am also going to post a review about my second steampunk girl Aurora soon, so please keep your eyes peeled if you're interested. So thank you so much for watching. Please like this video, comment if you want to tell me something. Please subscribe to my channel. I am working really hard to have videos for you all the way to the end of the year, and then I'm going to start with some Japan vlogs. So yes, thank you so much for watching, and bye!